How's it going, everybody? This is Blister coming at you with another classic WoW video. Today we're going to be going over another dungeon. It's going to be a little bit of a more simple dungeon. Today we're talking about the Stockades. Before we get into this video, I want to take a second to talk about classic WoW.live. If you like guides like this one, or other guides in general, whether it be classes, professions, dungeons, raids, make sure you head over there. There's a whole lot of good content over there for you guys to check out. It is a website built by the members of the community for the community, so it's a great place to find anything you need to know about Classic. Without any further ado, let's get into it. Before we actually get into the actual guide content and the quests and what to do in the dungeon, I want to take a second to talk about the background of the Stockades. For those of you who don't know, the Stockades are a well-guarded prison inside of Stormwind. A lot of the mobs in the Stockade are going to be members of the Defias Brotherhood. There are other named mobs that aren't necessarily members of the Defias Brotherhood, but they're in there nevertheless. A lot of those named mobs are going to be quote-unquote bosses, like we saw in the Deadmines, where they're a boss, but you don't really have to worry about the mechanics too much. And the other kind of cool thing I want to mention is that the only mob in here that actually drops any sort of BOP is a rare spawn. And when you think about it, it's kind of cool. You're in a prison, so all of the members in that prison should have had everything they own taken away from them when they went into the prison. So it only makes sense that when you kill a named mob, you're not going to go and get his axe, or you're not going to go and get his back piece, you're not going to go and get his shoulders, so on and so forth. So it's actually kind of cool what Blizzard did back in the day with this dungeon. Now let's get into the actual dungeon itself. So there's going to be actually 6 quests you can do in here. I guess they're trying to make up for the lack of gear that you are gonna get while you do this dungeon. So the first quest that we're gonna be able to get is Crime and Punishment, and there actually is some green rewards from this quest, so it definitely is worth picking up before you head in there. You're gonna need to go talk to Councilman Milstipe in Darkshire. This quest will have you go and get the Hand of Dextran Ward. Once you have the hand, you just head back to Darkshire, turn in the quest, and you get your green. The next quest we want to pick up is Quell the Uprising, and all you gotta do is just kill a bunch of different Defias members. And unfortunately, there is no green or blue or anything from that. You just get some XP from this quest, but it's still worth picking up. It's free XP. You're going to want to pick this quest up from Warden Thelwater in Stormwind. Warden Thelwater is actually going to have a second quest for you as well. And again, it's just more XP, but that quest is going to be called the Stockade Riots. And this is actually going to be part of a quest chain that starts with the Unsent Letter. And that can be started from Barriss Alexton, also in Stormwind. The Stockade Riots is the third quest in the chain. So you're going to want to also get that quest. Again, no greens, no blues, just some XP, but again, still nice to have free XP. The fourth quest that we're going to be picking up is also going to be located in Stormwind. It's going to be from Nikova Rosskull. This quest is called The Color of Blood, and it's very similar to the Deadmines quest that we had to do where we picked up the red bandanas. This time we need 10 red wool bandanas, and they're going to drop off of the Defias members. Again, this is just another XP rewarding quest, so don't be too bummed out when you don't get a green from it, but again, still free XP, nice to get. The fifth quest is going to be called The Fury Runs Deep, and you're going to pick that quest up all the way in the wetlands from Motley Garmison. For this, you're going to need to get the head of Cam Deep Fury. This quest actually rewards a green item, so it's definitely worth picking up, especially if you're out in the wetlands doing some questing, and then coming back to Stormwind and that area just to do some other questing. You run the Stockades, and you can go back out there and continue your questing. The last quest that we're going to pick up for the Stockades is What Comes Around. What Comes Around is going to require you to get the head of Targor, and is going to reward you with green items. The quest giver for this is Guard Burton in the Redridge Mountains. So once you get the head, head back over to him and you'll be able to get your green. So now for the dungeon itself, you're going to want to be level 26, level 27, maybe 28 if you're a tank before you go in there. Like I said before, it's located in Stormwind City. It's right outside of the Mage Quarter. It's really easy to find. So there are a total of 5 bosses, 6 if you include the rare spawn that actually gives you some loot. So the first boss that we're going to come across is going to be straight all the way down that first hallway that you go down. There's going to be a room at the end of that hallway, and inside there is going to be Targor the Dread. Now when you get to him, there's not really any abilities that you really need to worry about. He has an Enrage, which is not really much to deal with, just kill him quickly. And he has a Flurry, which is just 2 extra attacks. Now remember, if you did pick up all of the quests, Targor is going to give you his head, which will be for the quest What Comes Around, which goes to Guard Burton in Redrance Mountains. Once you've killed Targor, you're going to want to come out of that room and you're going to want to turn left, or if you're looking at the room that you just went into, you're going to want to turn right. And you're going to want to head down in that direction. There's going to be rooms on both sides of you again. Make sure you clear out the first two sets of rooms and the first room on the right after those first two sets. The room across from that is going to have your next boss. The next boss is going to be Cam Deep Fury. And again, this guy, not really much to worry about. He's a tank. He's got a tank stance. He's got shield slam. That's about all you really need to know about him. Cam is another one of the quest mobs for the Stockade. So once you kill him, you're going to need to take his head and bring it all the way to the wetland. So just make sure you got some other stuff to do when you go to turn that quest in. Next up in the big circular room, you're going to see right in the middle of that room is Hamhawk. Hamhawk is our next boss. He has two abilities that you need to be conscious of. They're not really much to worry about. You just got to force your way through it. He's got Bloodlust and Chain Lightning. The only thing you can really do is make sure you don't stand too close together, but don't stand too far apart so that way you're accidentally pulling mobs from the other rooms. But do what you can. Try and minimize the damage from the Chain Lightning for your healer. He's going to appreciate it very much. So, Hamhawk, unfortunately, is not one of our quest bosses, but we need to kill him to get to the next boss, who is in one of the rooms behind him. So after you kill Hamhawk, right behind him is going to be another room that has Bazeel Thread. Bazeel Thread has two abilities. He's got a Battle Shout and a Smoke Bomb, which is just an AoE stun. Make sure you worry about all the other mobs before you actually take them on, or make sure they're CC'd so that way you're not pulling the boss plus extra mobs. Bazeel Thread is another quest mob, so make sure you loot him once you're done killing him. You're going to get his head as well, and you're going to be able to turn that quest into Warden Thelwater in Stormwind. Now that we've cleared that wing out, we're going to want to turn our butts around and start heading down the other way. Once you go down the stairs, make sure you actually do clear out all of the rooms, because the first room on your right is where you can actually run into the rare spawn. The rare spawn's name is Brugal Iron Knuckle. He doesn't have any abilities to worry about, but he has three nice pieces of loot, so you're going to want to make sure that you check to see if he's there. But once you do all of that, you're just going to want to clear out all the rooms again, just like you've done on the other side, and head to the big circular room again. Clear out that big circular room, and the room directly across from the opening is going to be the room that has Dextran Ward in it. And Dextran Ward is our last boss of the instance, but again, he doesn't really have too much to worry about. Before you actually engage him, you're going to want to make sure you clear out the other two side rooms, because he does have an AoE fear. And if you run into those other side rooms, it's very easy to wipe. So make sure you clear out those other two side rooms before you engage him. Like I said, Dextran Ward is one of our last quest mobs, so you're going to want to make sure you loot him and get his hand. Once you have his hand, you'll be able to turn in the quest Crime and Punishment. For that, you're going to need to head all the way to Darkshire. And that's pretty much it. This is a really short dungeon. It's really simple. A lot of the quote-unquote bosses don't really have many abilities that you need to worry about. And that's pretty much it. So we're going to keep doing guides like this, guys. Let me know if there's one that you specifically want to see. I'm looking at trying to maybe do the Sunken Temple next. Sunken Temple is a bit of a longer dungeon, and it's going to be a little bit more complex, so the video is probably going to be a little long, but it's something I've always wanted to dig my teeth into. So anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.
Hey, it's Ratted here. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe as well. It really helps out the channel. We put out multiple new videos each week, and we appreciate all of your support. Thanks for watching, everyone, and cheers.